أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر
لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله رب العالمين نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ولن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه الله اليقين أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله ومن أصدق من الله قيلا وإن خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين In the name of Allah, the All Merciful, the Ever Merciful, and all praise and the blessings and salutations be upon the prophets and messengers from Adam alayhi salam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and sisters, tubtum wa taba mamshakum wa tabawwa'tum min al-jannati ghurafan wa manazila. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the last ayah in Surah Al-Qasas, chapter called the Qasas, وَلَا تَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرٍ كل شيء هالك إلا وجهه له الحكم وإليه ترجعون. Do not associate or call upon any other one other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولا تدع مع الله إلها آخر. Do not associate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you are in the moments of struggles and you need support and help. Do not even consider anyone is going to be beneficial to you in these moments other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kullu shay'in, everything is coming to destruction except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kullu shay'in halikun illa wajha. Lahu al-hukm, he has the authority, and to him alone you return. What I found very interesting, in majority of the ayat in the Quran, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about resurrection or the day of judgment or the end of our journey, it's always coming to that word, وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ إِلَيْهِ يُرْجَعُ الْأَمْرُ كُلُّهُ إِلَيْهِ الْمُسْتَقَرُ Like the word mustaqar or istiqrar comes from settling down. Settlements. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the settlements. So where are we at now? We're not in settlements yet. We're not settling down in this earth. We are passing by in the process or one of the phases of our journey. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only is the return. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah, after وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. To Allah subhanahu, we indeed belong to Allah, and to Allah alone we return. So what's interesting about that word in the Quran, that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about our journeys, that our journey eventually coming to return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not a destination, it's a returning back. So that's the original part for us. This is why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about al-hayat al-dunya and talks about our delusional or deceptional understanding of this word, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَسْأَلُكَ النَّاسُ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّ السَّاعَةَ تَكُونُ قَرِيبٌ. And also when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا دِينَهُمْ لَهْوًا وَلَعِبًا وَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا فَالْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاهُمْ كَمَا نَسُوا لِقَاءَ يَوْمِهِمْ هَذَا. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who take the religion as lahu, entertainment, wala'iba, and just something simple, they take it as a joke. وَرَضُوا بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, and also وَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, and this life has become a deceptional life for them. You know, when you are deceived by seeing something or hearing something or imagining something and is not truthful, that's exactly what this life is. By understanding that the joy of this moment, the joy of attaining embezzled money, or the joy of stealing something, or the joy of cheating, or the joy of arrogance, or the joy of being self-conceited, or the joy of any joy of this life that's temporary, it's considered a delusional joy. It's considered that this is, let me enjoy my moment and that's it. I do not believe in anything else. Maybe we say we believe, but in the moments of this joy that's haram, or it's considered sin, there's a shutdown of this belief. When the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لا يسرق السارق وهو مؤمن ولا يزني الزاني وهو مؤمن. Like in the moments of stealing, the thief is not a believer. What happened here? Is the shutdown of this iman by being in the delusional, momentary feeling of joy of stealing or attaining money, easy money. That's basically what is it. So the iman is shut down here. The true iman or the true belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the settling down or the resettlements is eventually to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is momentary shutdown. This is why the tawbah revives or returns or recharges that iman back. وَلَا يَزْنِ الزَّانِي وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. When somebody is committing adultery, indeed there is a joy in the process. Indeed there is a fulfillment of a sexual desire that's going out there. But that fulfillment is the indeed the exact delusional or deceptional moment of understanding, this is my joy right now, this is my life, this is my faith right now, to go to a level of orgasm or go to that level, and not forget and forgetting that there is a return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers, we have been talking about our journeys, and we talked about death and life after death. Today we will kind of like start talking about a different stage of our journey, or probably the stage before the eternal stage, which is called the last day. Or in other verses in the Quran, the day of resurrection. Or in other verses, as-sa'ah, the hour. And in another verses, al-yawmu al-akhir, the last day. Or yawmu al-qiyamah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ya ayyuhannasu, اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. O people, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, the shakening or the greatness moments of the sa'ah, of the hour, indeed is a great matter. يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا. In this moment, the physics is gone. All the laws are gone. All the laws come to an end. يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضَعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ. Like the mother, the maximum moments of love of between two human beings is when the mother is feeding the child. Is that deep connection between both. This sa'ah is going تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضَعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ. They're not attached anymore. Everyone is focused in themselves. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in Surah Al-Qiyamah, chapter called the Resurrection or the Day of Resurrection, لَا أُقْسِمُ بِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ وَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالنَّفْسِ اللَّوَّامَةِ أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَلَّا نَجْمَعَ عِظَامَةِ بَلَا قَادِرِينَ عَلَى أَن نُسَوِّيَ بَنَانَةِ بَلْ يُرِيدُ الْإِنسَانُ لِيَفْجُرَ أَمَامَةِ يَسْأَلُ أَيَّانَ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts narrating the moments or the changes that happened in this moment. So the biggest question for us, do we believe in this or not? That's a huge question. Because believing in this is a center in Islam. No one can claim to be a Muslim without believing in the Day of Judgment. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says at the beginning, from Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter number 2, Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And one of the descriptions of the muttaqin, الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَيُقُومُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالنَّصَارَى وَالصَّابِئِينَ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. So believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed attached to believing in the Day of Judgment. And in the Day of Judgment, everyone is accountable. That's what gives our life a purpose. That's literally what gives our life a purpose. When you know that your purpose in life, it's something, it's a journey towards the return. Where are we returning to? As Mustafa Mahmoud, one of the Egyptian doctors said, this is our end. This is where we're coming from. This is our source. We're returning. So usually when you return to your source destination. You're not going to somewhere. You return back to your source. And that's very interesting that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in majority of the ayat talking about the Day of Judgment is a day to return. A day to return. So we left from this source and we're coming back to that source. Let's narrate the hadith that's mentioned in the Sahih Muslim and that talks about a conversation between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and each one of us. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks to the human being, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَوَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِي لَا تُضَارُونَ فِي رُؤْيَةِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى فِي رُؤْيَةِ رَبِّكُمْ إِلَّا كَمَا تَضَارُونَ فِي رُؤْيَةِ أَحَدِهِمَا فَيَلْقَى الْعَبْدُ اللَّهِ فَيَقُولُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى أَلَمْ أُكْرِمُكْ وَأُسَوِّدُكْ like وَأَسُودُكَ like he made you a leader وَأُزَوِّجُكَ وَأُسَخِّرَ لَكَ الْخَيْلَ وَالْإِبِلَ وَأَذَرْكَ تَرْأَسُ وَتَرْبَعُ فَيَقُولُ بَلَى. So let's explain what that means. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to every one of us, haven't I honored you? Like sitting here right now, it's an honor. Understanding what's being said now, the language is an honor. The feelings is an honor. The creativity is an honor. The beauty, understanding, comprehending the beauty is an honor. The breath is an honor. The looks is an honor. Everything. Alam ukrimuk. Didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honor us? Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honors us. Well, sawiduk, I made you like the leader. And we know for sure, like while driving here today and looking down at the big buildings and the art everywhere in these buildings and these tons of amounts of cars and how we ended up inventing something like that that makes our destinations we can go faster than anything else and the planes and the sky and all of these things, and then painting and all of that. And saying like, didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us the leaders of this earth? Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us the leaders of earth. By a second, we can destroy this earth. In a matter of a second, with these mass destructive weapons. We can destroy the earth, and we can settle down and enrich this earth. وَأُزَوِّجُكْ Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make in ourselves the attachment between males and females? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes this in Surah An-Nahl, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes that connection is a miracle. There's a miracle in that connection and makes spouses. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعْلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأُسَخِّرَ لَكَ الْخَيْلَ وَالْإِبْلِ Like in the past, the khayla and ibl, these are like the transportation. Didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created that creativity in our minds to end up with tons of cars outside in the parking lot and trains and planes and all of these things that actually developed and made our life easier? وَأَدْرَكَ تَرْأَسُ وَتَرْبَعُ Like you are in charge of everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He says in Surah Al-Baqarah, when He created Adam alayhi salam, قَالُوا أَتَجْعَلُ When the angel says, when the malaika said, أَتَجْعَلُ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءَ وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ قَالَ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ And eventually, وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا ثُمَّ عَرَضَهُمْ عَلَى الْمَلَائِكَةِ فَقَالَ أنبئوني بأسماء هؤلاء إن كنتم صادقين قالوا سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم قال يا آدم أنبئهم بأسمائهم When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told our father Adam to tell the angels and to teach them قال يا آدم أنبئهم بأسمائهم What more privileges we need? What more privileges in this life we need? And with all of these privileges, we forget. But the second that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests us in something, we act as the first thing that we say, why me? Why Allah created suffering? And why is me? Allah created the free will in us and created the choice in us. So we choose to be good or bad. We choose to take this route or the other route. And some of us choose wrong routes. We choose to create the mass destructive weapons and we choose to create the medical tools to treat people in many ways. We choose everything. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَزَوِّجُكَ وَأُسَخِّرَ لَكَ الْخَيْلَ وَالْإِبْلِ وَأَذَرْكَ تَرْأَسْ وَتَرْبَعْ فَيَقُولُ بَلَى أَيْ رَبْ Yes, indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made all of this for me. فَيَقُولُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَفَظَنَنْتَ أَنَّكَ مُلَاقِي Have you ever believed that you are meeting me? فَيَقُولُ لَا وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ to be one of those people. Like after all of these privileges, have you ever thought that you are meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So I want all of us to imagine, not to imagine, to reflect or to contemplate. When we do any ma'asiyah, where is Allah in that moment? When is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the process of doing the ma'asiyah? Do we think that we are meeting Him? All of us do ma'asi, without exception. And the speaker is not any exception in here. But when we do it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's place in our hearts is reconciled. If His place in our hearts is very high, we will say, Ma'ad Allah. Let me get out of this. In the process. So, what we need to know, and what we need to believe, is to keep this belief revived always in our hearts, no matter the stumbles that we go through. No matter the moments that we tend to forget that we're meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you go trace the Quran and trace the Sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam and see the statements and the verses, you will see the moments we actually, the biggest problem, one of the biggest problems of the non-believers or the people that hypocrites is they do not go to a belief or a steadfast, solid, grounded belief that they are returning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the core of everything to our faith. That to believe that we are going to return. When? We do not know. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَالْيَوْمَ أَنْسَاكَ كَمَا نَسَيْتَنِي. And that's confirming the ayah that we just mentioned in Surah Al-A'raf, فَالْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاهُمْ كَمَا نَسُوا لُقَاءَ يَوْمِهِمْ هَذَا. So today I forget you as you have forgotten me. When I'udhu billahi to be one of those people who forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma inna na'udhu bika min dhalik. Here when the ulama was explaining what that means, they say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't forget. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala treats them the same treatment of someone doesn't care about another one. Like for example, another person probably you tend to forget. And that happens all the time. Like when somebody approach me and that person is very close or I know that person personally, usually I tend to finish what this person needs faster than a random person that shows up or approaches me. And this is something that can be normal sometimes. But we need to fight and do jihad to balance and not to favoritize people. And that's what we see all over the world. The favoritism and nepotism and the people choosing like my family first or my members first or my clan first or my tribe first or my people first or my ethnicity first or my race first and so on and so forth. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deal with that people. وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ أَن نَكُونَ مِنْهُمْ. The same treatment you deal with someone indifferently. Because you already first forgot Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَاللَّهُمَّ لَا تَجْعَلْنَّا مِمَّنْ يَنْسَاكَ. اللَّهُمَّ أَمِينَ. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله ولي الصابرين. الحمد لله أولا وآخرا. الحمد لله أبدا أبدا. الحمد لله عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلماته. لا نحصي ثناء عليه كما أثنى هو على نفسه. اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى ولك الحمد إذا رضيت ولك الحمد بعد الرضا. والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد. أما بعد, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks in the Quran about the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us like the grounding or some basic information that we need to believe in related to the day of judgment. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ السَّاعَةَ آتِيَةَ أَكَادُ أُخْفِيهَا لِتُجْزَى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا تَسْعَى. Indeed, the hour is coming. أَكَادُ أُخْفِيهَا, almost concealed. لِتُجْزَى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا تَسْعَى. Here in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about three basic beliefs related to the day of judgment, to the last hour. First, the day of judgment is indeed a fact. إِنَّ السَّاعَةَ آتِيَةَ. That's one. That's the basic belief. أَكَادُ أُخْفِيهَا. No human being, no other creature knows when the hour comes. That's number two. أَكَادُ أُخْفِيهَا. Number three gives us the purpose for that concealment. لِتُجْزَى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا تَسْعَى. يقول سيد قطب in his tafsir, usually the human being, psychologically, if we know the time of something, we become lazy until it's close. Like if we know exactly when we're going to die, we become do whatever, we psychologically we become a little bit lazy. It's still have 20 years, I still have 30 years or 5 years. Let me just wait until the last year and do the great work. So, but when it's concealed, when it's something that's not unknown, no, it's not known yet, the person knows any time the hour comes. Anytime the death comes, anytime the sickness can come to you, anytime the paralyzing life can come to you. You'll be surprised. Like I have one of my neighbors, back home, and he was like working constructions, and a very active person, mashallah, and goes here and there, and he works every day. And then when the COVID hit, he stayed in home for like almost a year. And after the year, the first day of work, he went to work, and then he fell off from like the third floor. And he is paralyzed now. One moment, 1 second, changed a whole shift, made a drastic shift of that person's life. And that person can be us anytime. Can be any one of us. We might be very strong, active, creative, go around here and there, and by the sudden, an accident, change everything in our life. And by the sudden, death changes everything. And by the and when the death comes, فَقَدْ قَامَتْ قِيَامَتُهُ, as the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, that's when you are done. Everything is done. So, when Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala also says in the Quran, فَهَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَّا السَّاعَةِ إِلَّا السَّاعَةَ أَنْ تَأْتِيهِمْ بَغْتَةً, are they waiting for the hour to come in a sudden approach? فَقَدْ جَاءَ أَشْرَاتُهَا, indeed, the signs of Sa'a has come. And that talks us about the fourth belief related to the Day of Judgment, that the Day of Judgment has signs. And the ulama have been talking about the signs coming back or relating to the hadith of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and some verses in the Quran. And that's when, inshallah, we're going to end up our Jum'ah today to talk, focus deeply in some of these signs. Some of them are minor signs, which means that it tells us it's close. When we do not know, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَسْأَلُكَ النَّاسُ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّ السَّاعَةَ تَكُونُ قَرِيبٌ. The people ask you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, عَنِ السَّاعَةِ, about the hour. Say, and this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches the most special human being, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the answer. He tells him what to say. Say, قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Period. Indeed, the knowledge of the hour is or belongs to Allah, and Allah alone holds that knowledge. قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ. And what do you think that the sa'a, that the hour might be close? So there are signs, and there are minor signs, almost like over 100 signs from narrations of the hadith of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we know almost all of them show up. All of them. Some people might know this in some societies other than other people, and inshallah we'll talk deeply about this. But let's wrap up this Jum'ah today and come up with something. As-sa'a, the hour or the Day of Judgment, centers our faith. The Day of Judgment is the core of how or we live our life, or what's called the lifestyle. The namatul haya. Our lifestyle should be based in the Day of Judgment, not should be based in the momentum or the temporary feelings of the moment. That shouldn't be, we shouldn't be those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described in the Quran, وَغَرَّتْهُمْ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا. The haya dunya deluded them. The life deluded them. What that means by delusion, that I live a lifestyle that I have no feeling or no belief in the part or no designations in my lifestyle that I am returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am a Muslim, I pray, I am good, but where is my lifestyle? How my lifestyle looks like? Is the Day of Judgment is returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is that belief that I believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is there or not? Do I forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala outside of the masjid or not? Do I remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in my business, in my work, in my interaction, in every aspect of my life or not? This is the big question. Because the sa'a teaches us this. The hour or the Day of Judgment or the last day or the Day of Resurrection remind us of this. And then we need to know that as-sa'a is unknown, as-sa'a is close, and as-sa'a, no one knows as-sa'a except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As-sa'a has signs, and when the sa'a comes or the Day of Judgment comes, do not ask about physics. Do not ask about laws, because it's completely different thing or different experience. فاللهم أعنا يا ربي على أن نحضر نفسنا ليوم الساعة. اللهم أكرم نزلنا اللهم وسع مدخلنا، اللهم لا تفتنا في ديننا، اللهم اقبضنا إليك غير مفتونين يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحمنا إنك عفو، اللهم ارحمنا واعف عنا، اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان، اللهم ارحم المستضعفين في كل مكان، اللهم ثبت قلوبنا على دينك، اللهم ثبت إيماننا يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تزغ هذه القلوب بعد إذ هديتها وهب لها من لدنك رحمة، إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار، وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم، وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، الله أكبر.